Alright guys, so we're back for another Dokkan Battle video, and today we're going to be talking about the 18th World Tournament. I'm not really that hyped about this, to be honest with you guys. I'm really tired. I've been grinding so much Dokkan Battle lately, and the World Tournament, I like the fact when it was only here every couple months on the global side. They just did one about a month ago, I believe it was. We grinded already so much, and I did get the reward that I wanted. But this guy, I'm not really a big fan of. First off, let's just go ahead and talk about it real quick. Tournament's going to start, has already started, last night at 10 o'clock PST or 10:30 PST. It ends on Monday at 10 p.m. PST. I believe it's 2 a.m. Eastern time, I believe it is now. Rewards will be distributed on the 15th, and then the summon banner, the guaranteed SSR banner, if you have that, and the Dragon Ball summons banner should run until 11:29. So we have, like, you know, that's not a really big deal for the summons. But let's go ahead and talk about the actual information. Alright, so the rewards, you can get this Vegito up until the top 10,000th rank. After that, you don't get him anymore, it's just SSR tickets. So for those of you who don't have like an AOE, good luck if you're really trying to get him. I really hope that you can. But it's going to be such a grind fest for you. And honestly, I don't think he's really worth it. Let's go ahead and talk about the card. Overwhelming Combat Strength Vegito. He is a base form Vegito agility card. His leader ability is agility type key plus 2, HP and attack plus 50%, so he's not a good leader. Not a good leader at all. He actually is kind of decent because he gives you the two most important stat buffs, which is HP and attack. So if you don't have any agility leader, you might want to consider going for him just because he will be a good stand-in for newer players until you get something better like a 70%, 90, like the Majin Vegeta 90% lead, or a 120 leader. But until then, you need someone who's going to be good. Even Khalifa would probably be better than him, because she also does the defense. But either way, if you don't have one, he'd be decent for an agility team. Super attack is Big Bang Attack. Causes supreme damage to the enemy, and all allies attack plus 20% for one turn. So when he launches a super attack, he's giving everyone else after him a buff. Problem is, with this card, he tries so hard to be the first unit, but his passive skill... It's hard because this passive skill also makes him want to be the first unit in the in lineup as well. Defense plus 100% as the first attacker in the turn, but he also gives super allies attack plus 30%. Now, he's not a hard-hitting unit at all. I know I discussed this in another video. He is not a hard-hitting unit whatsoever. He would only be utilized as a support unit because of that super type allies attack plus 30%. But you already have so many different types of units that give that kind of buff. I mean, you'd even take like the attack buff, the debuff, will lower attack, add some defense and get key, and you have a better unit that is, you know, that you could utilize instead of him as an agility unit. And I believe it was the World Tournament Gohan. Actually, I think he was strength, but there is, I think it was actually, no, the Super Saiyan 2 World Tournament Gohan is key plus 2, attack plus 20%. He might do defense. But let's talk about Link skill. Saiyan Warrior, Saiyan Lineage, prepared for battle, power bestowed by God, Fused Fighter, and Brainiacs. So in terms of Link skills, he has all of the good standard Link skills that a Vegito should have, but he also has Brainiacs, which is a little bit different. I don't think the other Vegitos actually have Brainiacs. So, oh, actually, the intelligence one does. I didn't realize that the intelligence one did. I don't know if the... Oh, these are all SRs. So, the intelligence Vegito is the only one who has it. The technique one doesn't, and I don't think none of the other Vegitos do. It's deck plus 10%, though, so that's decent. It looks like LR Piccolo does. I'm just trying to think of, like, a team that you could throw him on, like Weir. So, if Weir is an LR Piccolo, you could throw him on there for Brainiacs deck plus 10%. Too bad there's, like, no LR Gohan on here, and this is by rarity type. So it's not really like it's going to be too amazing. I think LR Piccolo would be your number one unit, possibly Paikuhan, the Super Paikuhan. But yeah, that's really about it. It's not too common of a Link skill and not too heavily utilized. So overall, he is a decent unit for Link skills. His passive skill allows super allies to get an attack buff, which is definitely viable. But that's about it. He's not really worth the grind. One thing I did want to state, he will be farmable from Full Force Power Vegito. This is an SR variant that is available on the JP side of Dokkan Battle. He drops from the new Super Vegito event, the actual physical one. Well, the actual event gets a revamp, right? So that is going to be available on the new stage over here, which is from Z-Hard, level 1, Miraculous Fusion. and you go up against the, and you get this base form Vegito. So when you go up against this base form Vegito, he could drop, and then you could awaken him. Actually, I think he comes awakened. So then you could feed him into all of your base form SSR Vegitos, base form Vegitos, and you can get their super attacks up to 10. So for those of you who have been holding on to those Vegitos or have been trying to like get his super attack up, you could start Baba-ing. After you get all the dupe pads unlocked, if you want to, you can start bobbing all those Vegitos. I know I will now, knowing that this is going to be a thing. I'll probably wait until he actually drops, and I'll bobble. Like, I think I have 15 base form Vegitos, and I'll just bobble all of them. anyway, so yeah, that's that. That's all there is to it. He's going to be farmable. He's a decent unit. I don't think it's worth the grind, but if you want to grind for him, go ahead. It's the top 10,000th place, so I might actually go for it. 10,000th place, you get him. You get one of him. You get one guaranteed SSR, three Dragon Ball Gold tickets, two Elder Kais, three Platinum statues, and then all the other basic stuff, which they really need to revamp this system because the rewards are not worth it. They should do like... Well, maybe for the 10,000 places, this is fine. But like when you start getting up there in rank, they should start increasing the amount of awakening medals you get and training items you get, because honestly, you did a grind. You should definitely get some more. You shouldn't just be able to awaken like two different characters. You know what I'm saying? But 10,000th place, I don't actually know how many you're going to get. I think it's usually like two or three. And then top 2,500 is usually three, I believe. Top 5,000 is usually two. And then top 1,000, I don't know. I don't know because it's not actually saying here. It's not displaying. Let me go ahead and check it out real quick. I'll be right back. All right, so I did just go and try to check out the Reddit, and I didn't find anything on the Reddit. Surprisingly, I didn't find anything on the Reddit. So I just went into the game because the World Tournament is live. So the top 10,000th is one Vegito. Top 5,000, 2,500 to 5,000 is Vegito, two Vegitos. Three Vegitos is 1,000 to 2,500. 100 to 1,000 is five Vegitos. 11 to 100 is seven Vegitos. 4 to 10th place is 10 Vegitos. Third place is 12. Second place is 13. And number one is 14. So you can open up all dupe pads and get them to super attack 10. Now, as that being said, again, I only think that you should go for the top 10,000. I don't think this is a great card. He's cool as a support unit, but there are better support units to have for a collector or collective purposes. Yeah, go ahead, grab him. He is going to be semi-farmable. He's going to be fully farmable in the future. It's not definitely not a bad thing to do. There are always good rewards. I mean, the thing is, two guaranteed SSRs, three Elder Kais. One guaranteed SSR, three Elder Kais. It's all right. I mean, the GSSRs are always awesome, but until they update the pool, speaking of, Mass Saiyan is now part of the pool, so you might have, you have a chance to pull him. Even though it's abysmal, you do have that chance to pull him. But outside of that, I mean, it's not really worth the grind, in my opinion, for this card, for this World Tournament, top 10,000, or just the mission rewards. And with that being said, let's go ahead and talk about the reward, other rewards. Obviously, local rewards. First place, two Piccolos, LR Piccolos, 40 Master Marks, and some Dragon Ball Saga summons, one Dragon Stone, one Hercule statue. Second place, this is kind of what I'm going for, not because of the LR Piccolo, but because of the 40 Master Marks. It's all I really need. I think I am actually set for like the foreseeable future with all Dokkan Awakenings from the World Tournament. It's just, I prefer to be prepared. You never know when they're going to drop another LR in the World Tournament. I'd rather have Master Marks for the future. Two Dragon Ball Saga summons, one Dragon Stone, and one Hercule statue. And then 4th to 10th place. So honestly, for me, local rankings anywhere between 2nd to 10th would be fine because of the Master Marks. I don't need them, but I would like to have them. I also don't like really going for 1st place. Obviously, unless I'm trying to go for global ranking for the World Tournament, doesn't really matter to me. But for local rankings, if I'm only focusing on that because I don't like the prize like this one, I usually try to let the 1st, 2nd, and 3rd place go to someone else because chances are they're going for the Piccolo as well. And since I already have mine maxed out, I don't really need to do that. Yeah, I know I'm a team player. Oh, Dokkanic, right? Anyway, so that's done. Piccolo's all around. I think you get Piccolo up until the top 100th. And then after, if you can't get the top 100, you don't get him yet. It definitely takes a long time if you only get to the top 100 because you want to make sure he gets Dokkan Awakened. But regardless, mission rewards. One win, two win, three win. We just go through here. Basic Dragon Ball Saga stuff for 10 wins up to... Yeah. All the 20 wins is essentially all Dragon Ball Saga summon tickets and some other cool prizes, like gravity chambers, essentially. A couple Dragon Stones, some training items, and some Senzu Beans. So, not really that great. Tier rankings are basic stuff, Dragon Stone, Hercule Statue, training items, support items, Dragon Stones. So, Yeah, really not that amazing until you get to, like, Supreme Kai tier with its 5 Dragon Stones. Elder Kai tier gives you an Elder Kai medal. I feel like they should give you 2, 1 of each, but whatever, what can you do? Beerus tier is the last one, which is 5 Dragon Stones, which is what everyone wants, because you want those Dragon Stones, definitely, for sure. Now, the points is really where you want to focus on, because the points is where the actual good rewards are. 2 Dragon Stones for the top 50,000, and then we can go 1 GSSR Silver Ticket. You need 5 of them to do 1 summon. For the first 1,000,000 points, and then you go Dragon Ball summons, GSSR Silver Ticket times 2, Dragon Ball Saga tickets, 3 Silver SSR tickets at 5 million points. Then we go, and then the next one, the next round of points that's really worth it is between 63 million or 6.3 million up to 6.7 million. All the small orbs of each individual type, 500 of each, which is really awesome. And then you have 7 million for the Elder or Supreme Kai. And then from 7.3 to 7.7 million. 300 medium orbs of each type, which is very, very useful. And then last is 8.3 to 8.7 million for all the large orbs, 20 of each type. Very much worth it, in my opinion. 9 million points, and then after the whole 9 million and on is really like where the... It depends on what your situation is. If you have Elder Kais, then this is awesome. If you, I mean, this isn't that great. If you don't have Elder Kais, this is definitely going to benefit you. 9 million points is going to be a guaranteed SSR gold ticket. 10 million is a Elder Kai. 15, 20 million is going to be 10 Dragon Stones between the two of them. And then you have 5 Elder Kais up to 30 million points. So actually, it's going to be a total of 6 Elder Kais from all the rewards up to 30 million. It's kind of worth it for you if you lack Elder Kais. I definitely don't, but I'm still going to be going for them because you can never have too many Elder Kais. At that point, I might consider getting my Barlot up to Super Tech 10. Who knows? Maybe. I don't know. Anyway, consecutive wins in a row. Really just basic rewards over here, Dragon Ball Saga summons and SSRs. There's really not a lot of gold SSR tickets in this World Tournament. It's definitely going to deter a lot of players, unless you're a hardcore player, from actually going in. So chances of, if you guys want some good rewards, like from the actual placement, this might be the World Tournament for you, just because there's not a lot of people are going to be going ham on this tournament. I did see some people on Facebook talking about how they really want that Vegito. Personally, I think he is an overrated character. I don't think he's that great. But if you want to grind for a place to get a whole bunch of these rewards, like the top tier rewards over here, this is probably going to be the World Tournament to do it, just because I don't see a lot of people going for this grind. But I don't know. Let me know down in the comments below if you plan on doing that. Now, before we wrap up today's video, I did want to go ahead and do a little bit of a team building guide sort of on here. I'm going to go ahead and try to expand this in. It might get a little bit blurry for you. So this is the Vegito, right? I already have the filter set up for 4 or more link skills for every card in the game. He doesn't link with anyone for 4 or more, which is really weird. Anyway, so I did do 3 or more, and if you see over here, once you drop it down to 3, how many he links with, this is a little bit too convoluted, so we're going to go ahead and just stick with UR and LR, and we're going to go ahead and see what we can do here. But you know what, let's go ahead and also take out the extreme types and keep the super only, because it doesn't make sense to have extreme types there since he's not going to benefit them. So the primary grade A units that he's going to benefit are going to be obviously the 2 Vegitos and the fused Gotenks, the physical one that Dokken Awaken. Fused Fighter Saiyan Warrior, or Saiyan Blood, and prepared for battle, which is awesome. The other one is going to be this Gohan, which is also power bestowed by God. Saiyan Blood and Battle Ethic Saiyan, not really that great, so it doesn't link too well with him. The B rank cards, at least ones that I consider B rank, are these ones on the bottom, which you can see over here. Karoli, the base form Gotenks, Barlot, which some of you may have, some of you might not have, the other Super Saiyan Gotenks, and the Ultimate Gohan. The other ones that are kind of crappy rank, at least ones I don't like, I don't really like this agility one. I know so many of you guys like the agility Ultimate Gohan. I'm not a fan of him. I think he sucks on a mono agility team, because if he stuns the enemy, Super Vegito is not getting off his counters, and it hurts the team more than it helps the team. Or at least it makes the event go on a lot longer than it needs to. This Bardock, I believe this is the Bardock who is a support unit, so it's not like they would ever link together anyway. Even if they did, they don't give each other that much in terms of attack buffs. And I believe this is a crappy Goku. I believe this is the Super Saiyan Goku that just dropped on the most recent banner. I think he's a category lead. Don't hold me to that. But overall, he doesn't really link well with anyone. So, yeah. Decent link skills, I guess, for basic link skills. But he's more of a key source for a couple of the Fuse Fighters, specifically the Super Vegito and the Vegito Blue. Outside of those two, he's not really doing anything for attack. He's just giving off key, which so many units now do. So he's not. That's why I don't think he's viable. Attack plus 30% is great, but you have other units that do that. But anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today. That's my opinion on the new World Tournament. I'll probably gonna grind out just to get one because I like to collect the cards, and he will be fully farmable in the future. But other than that, I don't think it's worth it. Go ahead, at least go for the missions. That's what I would recommend to you. But make sure to subscribe if you're new, and I'll catch you guys later.